Once again, I welcome you all. As you know that these leadership talk sessions are being organized by India International Education Council and School Lalaji Solutions. India International Education Council is a not-for-profit organization which is working in the field of education. It has collaborators from 12 countries. It aims to create a better world through education, building quality centers for elementary education which are approachable for all kids. It's also trying to find the best educational practices across the globe and find ways to implement those in Indian institutions. It is also creating more awareness on hygiene and learning disabilities. It publishes a magazine called World Education Review and many other educational reports. It aims to build 100 chapters in different cities by 2022. It will soon open its membership for institutions and individuals, but also impart training for leaders, teachers, students, and parents. As you know that so far we have conducted 133 sessions. We have received 15,889 registrations, 14,623 questions on national education policy. Educators from 5 countries have participated: India, USA, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, Nepal. From India, we have seen participation from 22 states and more than 108 cities. We aim to organize minimum 200 sessions. With this, we will be reaching out to 100,000 educators, 20,000 students, and 1,000 plus eminent speakers, like today's speakers, would be joining us to share their perspective. Eventually, we would be compiling all the thoughts into a document, and we would be presenting the document to the Ministry of Education, CBSC, other national and state boards, and other stakeholders. So with this, I would request you all, please join me in welcoming our key speakers for this very special 134th session. Our first key speaker, very senior education leader, Neeraj Vohra, ma'am. Neeraj, ma'am, is principal with Tritiksha Public School, Rohini, Delhi. She's a seasoned educator with more than 26 years of experience in the field of education. She has an MSc, B.Ed., Ph.D., HRM. She's also a GATE qualified, also qualified with NET. She has always given 100% result in class 10th and 12th while working as PGT, and also received Best Teacher Award in Army School in 1999. During her tenure as principal, she has received an award from respected Murali Manohar Joshi ji, who was the then Honorable Minister of HRD. That was organized by All India Book Association in 2015. She's also received Best Principal Award from Avantika Rashtriya Seva Samman. She's also received a Best Principal Award from Bharati Vikas Parishad. She's also received Dr. Radha Krishnan Award on September 5, 2020 from Eminent Educationist Forum while working with Anglo-American School in Moscow. She's also working first in exposure of She has been appointed as a resource person by CBSC for various workshops and by various other teaching agencies. We welcome you, Neeraj ma'am. Thank you for joining. It's an honor to have you. Our next speaker, another senior education leader, Rashmi Goyal ji. Rashmi ma'am is principal with the Sapien School of Herbertpur, Uttarakhand. She has an MA in English and B.Ed. She's into education for last more than 35 years, since 1990. She has worked as a PGT English from 1997 to 2012, as well as senior coordinator. She also worked with the Sapien School, Vikas Nagar, as vice principal. Since 2018, she has been the principal with the Sapien School, Herbertpur branch. She is also associated with the RS Samaj Group and Ladies Club to contribute whatever little could be done to guide the works of social welfare. A number of workshops are addressed about how to deal with teenagers, Rashmi ma'am. She has been awarded by the National Body of Agrawal Samaj, Lions Club, and Vaishya Mahila Sabha for extraordinary contribution to the field of education. Her students are sprinkled all over the country as well as outside India who are still in touch with Rashmi ma'am. Big thanks, Rashmi ma'am, for joining. It's an honor to have you. Our next key speaker, another senior education leader, KCS Mehta ji. Mehta sir is the director of academics with International Delhi Public School, Akhnoor, Jammu and Kashmir. He's a dynamic professional with 36 years of experience in teaching, operations, administration, and curriculum management. He's a dedicated and self-motivated leader with proficiency in handling the administrative activities upholding the institution's motto. He started his career as a PGT maths. He has also served as principal at Army Public School Akhnoor for 15 years. He's also the resource person to train principals and teachers of various Army public schools in India. He has received very prestigious Chief of Army Staff commendation. We welcome you, Mehta sir. Thank you for joining. It's an honor to have you. Our next speaker, Dr. Shruti Sharma ji. Shruti ma'am is principal with the GC Goyal International School, Agra, Uttar Pradesh. She has done BCom, MA English, MA Education. She has also done PhD, qualified with UGC NET. She has an experience of over 24 years in the field of education. She has attended and conducted various faculty training programs on teacher strategies, classroom management, life skills, and implementation of CC in schools. She has also attended CBSE mandated workshop for school principals 2014-15 on mentoring of new staff and motivating experienced staffs conducted by Exceed Institute. She has also presented many papers at various platforms. She has also worked with many prestigious schools during her entire journey. She has also worked as a center superintendent for CBSE examination, AISSE and AISSCE, CTET and UGC NET since 2013. She has also been recognized and awarded many times for her contribution to the institution. We welcome you, Shruti ma'am. Thank you for joining. It's an honor to have you.
Thank you.
Our next key speaker, Dr. Anjali Priyadarshini ji. Anjali ji is assistant professor with SRM University, Haryana. Dr. Anjali is an assistant professor in the Department of Biotechnology, Biomedical Engineering since 2017. She has done her postgraduate from Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi, and a doctorate from Postgraduate Institute of Medical Education and Research, Chandigarh. She has more than 12 years of teaching and research experience from Delhi Technological University, University of Delhi, and PGIMER, Chandigarh, where she has worked on infectious diseases, the development of biosensors and non-material. Her research interests are infectious disease, immunology, biosensor, and cancer biology. She was recently awarded with a project by ICMR and has published 4 books. Welcome you, Anjali ma'am. Thank you for joining. It's an honor to have you. Our next speaker, another very senior EdTech leader, Jaswinder Singh ji. Jaswinder sir is the founder and CEO of Bosworth ELT. Jaswinder sir has an experience of 30 years in the field of education and technology and has also served as a consultant to UNESCO and education. Bosworth English Lab is designed for India and is a highly research initiative of the Ek Univ Group. It is a trusted educational company with 2 decades of service in technology, education and training. Its expertise in technology, multimedia and content development has been instrumental in presenting a world-class language lab solution for the academia in India. In a short span of time, Wordsworth English Language Lab has managed considerable recognition across the country for its unique content and methodology. Over 3,000 installations in institutions across the country stand testimony of the quality in product implementation. Training and the continual service provided by ActUniv and its committed network of dealers. We welcome you, Jaswinder sir. Thank you for joining.
Thank you, Rajuji. Thank you.
Welcome, sir. And our last key speaker for this very special session, Savio John ji. Savio is the national head of quality with Torrens. Savio is a professional musician, specifically a singer, songwriter, and guitarist. He has been performing since a very young age and has toured multiple cities performing in various venues. He's also a gospel musician and has featured on multiple TV shows. He's currently working with Torrens Music and heading quality and delivery excellence in India. Since the past 8 years, he has been working with institutions engaged in vocational education, handling business development, strategy, and implementation. Savio has been vocal about making music a compulsory subject in schools, as the creativity, discipline, and communication that it demands would help students become better individuals. Savio has also authored the vocal curriculum for Torrens and conducts vocal workshops across various schools. We welcome you, Savio. Thank you for joining. It's an honor
Thank
to
you.
Have you.
Thank you, Rajulji. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you and welcome, sir. So with this, we come to the next part of the session, which is the opening remark part. I would be coming all our key speakers, for your 1 minute opening remark. Now, first, I would request Neeraj Vora, ma'am. If we can have your opening remark. Neeraj Vora, ma'am, if you have your presence. I believe Neeraj ma'am is yet to join. I would request Rashmi ma'am if we can have your opening remark. Rashmi ma'am.
Yeah, sure. Good morning, everyone. And first of all, I just thank you, this India International Education Council, for giving me this platform to express myself. And of course, we need an extensive and very comprehensive discussion on the topic so that the clarity may be more. And today, I think that this is the most sorted out and most answered topic, that what are the challenges before the 21st century teachers particularly. So I'll be expressing myself on the same topic, and that will be just getting out of my own experiences as a teacher, as a principal. So I will be sharing with all those things so that we can have a better interaction. I would really request all the people to come with their queries if they have any, so that we can have a very interactive session with that. So thank you very much, Mr. Anjur, for giving me this chance.
Thank you, Arashi ma'am. I'll come back to you. Now I would request Mehta sir. Mehta sir, if we can have your opening remark. Sir, you are on mute.
Am I audible now, sir?
Yes, sir.
Good morning, everybody. As I am very much thankful to organizers for organizing such type of events, which will be fruitful for our teachers, for our students, to understand what this new education policy, what are its impacts, and what type of preparation schools has to do for implementing these policies to make this 100% successful. Otherwise, these things remains on papers only. So good initiative, and my compliments to the organizers, and thanks for giving me an opportunity to be a part of this webinar.
Thank you, Mehta sir. We all are very excited with your presence, and we are also very excited to hear your ideas. Big thanks for joining. I'll be coming back to you. Now I would request Dr. Shruti Sharma ji, Shruti ma'am, if you can have your opening remark.
Very good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible, sir?
You're audible, ma'am.
After over 3 decades, the education system in India will be rehealed completely. The cabinet has approved the national education policy, which envisages a complete relook at how people are to be educated in India, and it includes looking once more at the boards, exams, the medium of instructions. And I'm glad to be a part of the discussion today. I myself have been in the field of computer science for many years, and have done UGC NET and PhD in education. Right to education had come up in 2000, and I would be glad to discuss and be a part of this.
Right, ma'am. Thank you, Shruti ma'am. I'll be coming back to you for your main talk. Big thanks for joining. Now I would request Dr. Anjali Priyadarshini ji. Anjali ma'am, if we have your presence, so can we have your opening remark? I believe Dr. Anjali is to just so Anjali ma'am, you were just calling your name. So coming back to you, just take a breath. I'll come back to you after Jasinder sir. Jasinder sir, I would request you, if you can have your opening remark, then I'll come back to Anjali ma'am.
Yeah. Good morning, everybody. We are here to discuss a very disruptive policy. And I basically am from the edtech industry, catering to language development. So my focus is going to be on both how technology can help us achieve the milestones or the goals that this policy has set for us as educationists. And the second is that there's a lot of change and a lot of recommendations that have been put up onto the kind of language that should be used for early foundation years, and how the local language or the mother tongue is going to help. How is it going to impact our learning and the way we teach English to our students? So that is what my focus is going to be. I look forward to the remaining part of the session. Thank you.
Thank you, Jaswinder sir. I'll be coming back to you. Now I would request Anjali ma'am. Ma'am, if you can have more opening
remarks. Yeah, a very good morning to all. And thank you, Rajul ji, for again making me a part of this fruitful discussion. So as like I am from the higher education, and I am a faculty in biotechnology and microbiology. Like it's an interdisciplinary, like NEP, it lays a lot of importance on this interdisciplinary approach for all the education being imparted, and on top of that in your mother tongue. So my opening remark would be ki let's join together to make this vision true for the benefit of our students as well as benefit of our country. Because see, if we are making a person expert in one particular field and who is oblivious of the other aspects being affecting that field, so we are not making a complete thing. So it's like that some blind people looking at, it's a very old story, looking at a elephant, somebody's touching the tail, somebody's touching the trunk, and they're making out their own pictures. So we need to give a holistic approach to our students to make this vision as has been designed for the benefit of all of us. Thank you.
Absolutely, Anjali ma'am. Big thanks for that. I'll be coming back to you. Now I would request Mr. Sevi John. Sevi, if we can have your opening remark.
Yeah, thank you, Rajul ji, for having me over. It is indeed a privilege to be in the presence of such an august gathering of educators from across the country. Well, the NEP speaks about formally introducing subjects like arts, classics, history, literature, and for the first time ever, there is such a lot of consideration given to the whole idea of music overall. As you know, we know that there have been over 20 times that music has been mentioned in the NEP 2020. And I feel that well-formed courses at the fundamental level is going to lead to a proper selection of course choices later on. And I'm looking forward to the rest of the discussion. Thank you.
Thank you. Sevio, for that. So with this, we come to the next part of the session, and which is the main talk part. I'll be coming back to all our key speakers for their main talk. All these speakers will get 8 to 10 minutes for their, for sharing their perspective. But before I invite our first speaker, I just would like to share the learnings which we have had during our last 133 sessions. During our last 133 sessions, almost every participant share that this is a wonderful document. This document has a potential to place India at that coveted position of Vishwa Gyan Guru.
At the
same time, almost same number of participants share that this is going to be very, very difficult to execute. This is such an ambitious document. Many people believe that finance is going to be a key concern area. Many educators who participated share that teachers' training is going to be a concern area. Many educators believe that teacher training, yes, is going to be a concern area, but the bigger concern area is lack of intent among teachers to get trained. A lot of people, as I said in the beginning, cited the example of CCE, that it is was also a wonderful document, but got failed due to various reasons. Many people also shared that good schools in urban areas are already implementing many of these ideas. Biggest challenge would be for rural schools, budget schools, and government schools. Many people also shared that, you know, this pandemic exposed the poor distribution of digital infrastructure in our country. That is also going to be another big challenge. So I would request you all our key speakers, that while sharing your perspective, if you can also suggest some ideas, some solutions, some best practice, you know, based upon your decades of experience. So that would make this session more meaningful for all of us, you know, so that we can all learn from each other in collaboration. So once again, big thanks for joining. Now we'll begin the main talk session. I would request all our speakers that please keep the time limit in mind so that we have sufficient time in the end for the questions. Time limit is 8 to 10 minutes. So once again, I welcome you all. I would request our first speaker, Rashmi Goyal ma'am. Rashmi ma'am, if we can have your detailed perspective. And meanwhile, I would recognize the presence of Sunita Rawat ma'am, our principal, Anurag Public School, Dehradun. Welcome, Sunita ma'am. Thank you for joining. And now I would request Rashmi ma'am. Rashmi ma'am, over to you.
Okay, fine. Thank you, Mr. Ranjul, first of all. As you have been stating, whatever we have just gone through the last sessions, and there had been many doubts, many questions on the implementation of the things. So I would just like to suggest one thing, that as my perspective and as my experience, actually, there is always, always a solution when we are intending to find out a solution. That is our urgency, which is required, actually. The interest, the urgency, the curiosity, and then we can find out the solutions for everything. As we are raising so many points, and I think the foremost point is there, that how the teachers can be trained. Somewhere I have read that if we want to teach the parenting to the parents, that is not actually taught. They are simply drawn their attention towards certain points because they themselves are the best parents. Nobody can advise the parents to be a good parent. In the same way, I personally feel that every teacher is the best teacher. And to find out the solutions to their problems, they themselves can really find out the solutions. So many things are there on the technologically advanced platforms. Therefrom, we can just do that. And particularly, if we are really having an interactive session between the teachers themselves also, so sharing their experiences, then also we can learn a lot, many things from there. I'm coming to the same point over here also, that as I have told that I will be focusing on the topic, that is challenges before technology, before teachers in 21st century. If we just list them, then there are certain things that today we need the personalized teaching, because days are gone when the teacher was a lecturer and the students were the patient listener, following the dictums and dictates from the teacher, noting them down in the notebooks and all those things which were very traditional. And of course, at that time, the best classroom was, which is a peaceful zone to carry on the education process. But now the time has changed. Even in my career of more than 35 years, I have also gone through a number of changes of the patterns and environment of the classrooms. Today we can count upon the best classroom, which is chirruped by the queries of the students, by the discussions of the student. Even someone has said that is the best teacher who makes his student speak 80% and himself he speaks only 20%. So the formula has completely changed. And in this changed environment, we can have the different answers to all the challenges. Taking up first as the personalized, we are saying, personalized means we have to answer, we have to cater the need of every learner. For that, I see that KYC is the best formula, means know your child. Once the teacher has to come across his child in a personal manner, with a little pat, with a little discussion over his interest topics, at that time we can get the confidence of the student very easily and we can know him better. And to make our teaching more effective, we have to, of course, adopt different ideologies, different patterns, different styles of delivering. We have to make the students interact. When the students are interacting, at that time, of course, we can answer their queries also. And means we can just touch the core of the student's personality and then can imbibe the different topics of our education. As we know that there are so many people before us in a class, 30, 35 students are there. Somewhere 40 students also are there. So you may be surprised that 40 students, but if we just look into the things very particularly, we will be seeing that all those 40 students can be described as the bunch of three or four type of students. Once we are into that, we can automatically develop such a curiosity, that such a method which can involve all the students. And if in one single class we are interacting with 6-7 students personally on the personal level, of course the whole class can be touched within 3-4 periods very easily without creating much disturbance. And in a way, a personal connection can be established where the student also may feel himself appreciated, that student may feel himself that teacher is teaching me. And at that time, there can a personalized teaching may go very smooth. So this is one thing. So increased interaction, I must say, increased interaction can be the answer to that. The second point is right use of technology. I think pandemic has taught us a lot, even to the old teachers like me, who have read in the initial stages, computer like something very out of the world thing. Now we are sitting before the computer and using it without any technical, of course, help from any outside. Why? Because we thought we should use it. We should be expert. We should be having hand-on on this technology. We did that. In the same way, anybody can do it. And I have experienced this, my experience with in some other group also, where in some conclave. So here also, I'm just interested to mention the same thing, that every school is the bunch of the cluster, a bouquet of different teachers, where some of the teachers are technologically very advanced and some are little struggling with their problems. So what the other person we need? Why do we need other person to have the workshop and teach us the technologies and all that? Why can't we make an interactive session between the teachers and they can help each other very easily to find out all the solution? And in our school, I'm proud to share that really our novice teachers, they were taught how to teach by the expertise people. And these new teachers, they taught the use of technology to our teachers who were out of that track. So use of technology is good, but I will try to find out, to draw your attention towards one thing, that to make that digital learning process easy, now we are moving towards a number of outsourced resources. EdTechs, education technologies, we are outsourcing from YouTube, from so many different channels. But my dear students, my dear teachers, I would like to draw your attention towards one thing. Aap kahin se bhi padhiye, kahin se bhi lijiye, but the main thing is there. Your personal touch should be added to that videos. Remake those videos with your own personal touch, with your own knowledge, according to the suitability of your class, according to the perspective of your students, according to the demands to your students. And then that technology use also will be your hand-on activity. You will not be faltering upon the technological problems. So instead of completely outsourcing the digital informations for our students, we should learn to make our own videos, to make our own technological or digital education lessons, so that the students can really feel that they are being taught by their teacher. Then they will be more connected. Otherwise, generally what happens? Are YouTube link at some other time, we shall see to that. No. They should feel that this is our teacher is teaching us. Then of course, the technology also. And I'm sure, dear teachers, that technology is not such a big elephant which you cannot touch, as Ma'am Anjali has just shared, that this is just like a elephant. Everybody is touching, somebody is touching his tail, somebody's ears, somebody's trunk, and everybody is defining its own way. But it will not be your, it should be your definition, but it should be according to the needs of your classroom. So we can answer these technological falters also very easily. Third point, as I'm trying to manage the timing also, I'm just coming up to the point, that is classroom management. Now we can see very easily, when we started teaching 35 years back, at that time, there was hardly any exposure to the outside world. No student was sitting before the television. there were no YouTube channels, there were no Google things, there were no such things which could draw the attention of the student. And in the houses also, I can share, and I am sure many of you also would agree with me, if we have to say any complaint against any teacher in the home, we would get a slap. Tumhari kami hogi. So it was not at that time. There was such an environment that 100% the student has to bow before the teacher, whatever right, wrong. Nobody was there to question anyone. Nobody was there. The teacher was the highest authority, the God's word, jo keh diya final. Ma'am ne ye kaha hai final. And I can really share with you that sometimes the parents would come in, ma'am, please, आपने ये छोटी सी गलती कर दी, बट माई स्टूडेंट माई वार्ड इज नॉट रेडी टू एक्सेप्ट इट, प्लीज आप ही बताइए कि दैट हाउ टू डू दिस करेक्ट. एंड टीचर यूज टू फील सॉरी सॉरी मैम आई विल करेक्ट इट, बिकॉज फॉर टीचर फॉर स्टूडेंट द टीचर वॉज द गॉड. बट नाउ द स्मॉल चिल्ड्रन ऑल्सो हैज द कैपेबिलिटी टू क्वेश्चन द टीचर, नो मैम आई हैव गूगल्ड, दिस इज नॉट दिस, दिस इज दैट. इवन द when the child is opening his eyes, he is opening his eyes towards the mobile. So from the very beginning they go to the school, even before that they have learned how to handle the mobiles and how to Google the things. In such an environment, when the student are over there in the classroom, this is very difficult to manage them, because there are so many distractions, so many things to talk, so many things to discuss with their partners, and they can really raise sometimes the questions which may sometimes make you feel odd in the classroom if the teacher is not completely prepared with their subject. So the full command on our knowledge only can make us a charismatic person before the students. And a charismatic person, a magician only can really handle, but you have to get that magic in your teaching, in your own knowledge. Though this is a saying that jack of all is master of none, but now really the requirement is that the teacher should be jack of all. And I'm really saying it with my experience, there is no harm if you can say, beta, this subject I can deal with confidence, this subject I will check, instead of telling them wrong. This is always better. Tell them clearly, I will check and then I will come to the answer to your question. And make it sure that with the next opportunity, answer these students in their proper way. So these are certain things. Means aapko, you have to just grab the mind of the student so that they may have a full confidence. So as Vivekananda says, first win the confidence, then come to the argument.
Right.
So first you have to win the confidence of the students, and then you can come to the arguments with them, and then you can definitely deliver whatever you want to do.
Right.
Next point is curriculum. For curriculum,
I would request the time limit.
May I know, sir, how many minutes I am left with?
You have already exceeded by 4 minutes, ma'am. So I would request, if you can, please conclude your thought. Please take 30 more seconds and conclude your thought.
Okay, sir. So I just wind it up. Curriculum, global awareness, they were two other things in my agenda. But I'm just concluding my thing so that I may not be setting a poor example, actually. That the best thing to answer all the challenges is that first, you involve yourself, you take your own education, your own knowledge of the subject with perfect foundation, and then you can answer any question, any challenge very eagerly, very perfectly, and leaving a good implementation, a good impression on the minds of the students. So now, thank you, sir. I'm just winding.
Okay. Thank you, Rashmi ma'am. You actually presented a template for all the teachers, how teachers can be empowered, how we can make our teaching more effective.
So yes, sir. Yes.
You talked about if teachers get empowered, they have these solutions for every problem. Teachers can create magic, but they need to be empowered. You also talked about that today's teachers need to focus on individual attention. They must know their child, they must know their children, you know, individually, and they need to be innovative. You also talked about that a unique bond between a teacher and student creates magic. You know, so teachers need to find ways how that, you know, that kind of bond can be created. And you also shared practical examples, and you also shared one very strong assessment that school is a bouquet of teachers with different kind of skill sets. School don't need to go outside for any kind of thing if they can use their own resources properly. So many of our senior educators have also shared these thoughts during our past sessions as well, that school have you know, many resources inside its infrastructure only. You also talked about, you know, why teachers must focus on creating their own content, you know, to become more efficient rather than just, you know, outsourcing or just sharing some, you know, forwarded content to their students. And in the end, you talked about your very strong assessment that today's students have far, far, far bigger resources of information than teacher alone. Today's students don't come to teacher for the information. They come to teachers for the perspective. So teachers
need to check them.
Absolutely. Thank you.
You know, one second, Mr. Ranjul, please. Thank you very much for compiling and just in such a short nutshell, you have really put up my views in a very beautiful way. Thank you very much for this concise way. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. I have a practice of last 133 sessions, so I have improved my lessons. Thank you, Rishi, ma'am. Big thanks. I'll be coming back to you with questions. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, sure, sir, sure.
Now I would request KCS Mehta, sir. Sir, you have a very diverse experience. You know, you have worked with forces. You have worked with the schools which are not affiliated with forces. You know, I'm sure you, when you look at this policy, you look at it from different perspective. So your thought would be highly valuable. KCS Mehta, sir, over to you.
Thank you very much, sir, for giving me opportunity to share my experiences and to say a few things on this policy, sir, because this is need of the hour, sir, because we are working in the field of education and we have to keep in mind the comparative education. Whatever is happening in the entire world, we have to be in race. We have to train our students, teach our students in such a way that we are at par with other countries, education system of other countries, and our students be able to take admission, to go as professionals, to work anywhere in the world. In this policy, sir, as beautiful things which has been created, which has been introduced, is that preschooling, sir. Preschooling was in the private schools, that nursery, lower KG, upper KG, we used to have in public schools, but this was not part of the curriculum, part of the schooling. Now they have given place to this preschool, sir. This has been regulated by introducing this 5+3+3+4. This is wonderful thing, sir. And now the schools, which were preschools, they were opening, so many people were coming with this idea that they are going to start preschools. Now these are the formal schools. There will be a proper check. There will be a proper curriculum now. They are now, they have been regulated, sir. Second thing is that this age, which has been given that prior to this, 5+ was supposed to be in class 1. Now it is 6+ or 7 years of age. It will be in, when the students are mature, they know the value of education, they know their system. They are in class 1. Otherwise, class 5 was not fit for class 1. Age 5 years of age will be now in KG. And they will be in class 6. Then school age, sir, previously existing, it is 6 to 14. Now it will be 3 years to 18 years. I think now this is mandatory that nursery has been introduced in the schools now. Right, sir, for the preschool, there was no curriculum. Schools were planning their books. They were, I was surprised to see, sir, one day, I visited a school, sir. They were having a these competitions, some activities were there. I went there because my school was participating. I was prior to this, I was in APS Akhnoor. I worked there as principal for 14 years, sir. And the chairman of that school, he took us on the round. And he, first of all, he took us in class nursery, sir. And I was surprised, he, one SSP, one DIG was with us. He was, probably he show us seats of the books which we have introduced in these nursery classes. These were books, sir, of very high level books. And I told him, sir, this is not the age to read these books. This is preschool. We have to prepare them. We have to work to develop their skills, these motor skills, even speaking skills, running, sitting together, working together. And why you are teaching them these hard subjects? He told me, no, sir, we are having exams. We are having their annual days. And I was surprised to see that this is crime we are doing with these small kids. This is age when they should be in schools. They should run. They should do some paintings. They should. We have to develop them. We have to. It is both growth and development, sir. We have to see both the things. But when we are putting them in such a pressure, giving them such hard books to read, sir, it was surprising to see, sir. And now, sir, one more good thing is that vocational education, which was not in the existing system, sir. I remember in 70s. Vocational education was there, sir. At that time, sir, shorthand, typing, and carpentry was there, sir, in class 11th and 12th. These were called core and elective classes, sir. Now, this has been introduced and will be from class 6, which is a very good thing, sir. As we have seen that in Delhi, government of Delhi, they have decided to have their own board. And when student will pass class 12, he will, with academic, he will get ITI certificate also. That this child is fit for electrician. He is fit for carpentry. He is fit for that cooking. He is fit for this agriculture. He is fit for horticulture. So they will get that that skill development will be there with academics also, sir. And this is very good thing. That now in our education system, new education policy, we have introduced this. This will be mandatory from class 6. So this is very good thing, sir, vocational and coding. This will be also from class 6. Now students will not be dependent that they should go to other these private coaching centers to learn these codings. This will be now in the schools. And as I was very happy to when ma'am was Rashmi ma'am was interacting. She was giving her views about that KYC, know your child. This is very good. And technology, she has also included this technology in schools. This is in schools now. This is mandatory that schools education planning, teaching, learning, assessment, and management, they all will use the technology. As we face a lot of problems when we had these lockdown and we started online classes, schools were not ready to have this system. But under compulsion, we started this, and now teachers are used to of using this. Now teachers have gained these things, the experience. They can impart now offline as well as online education. Now the use of technology is very important aspect, which has been in this new education policy, sir. And most important thing is that we have to empower our teachers. We have to keep stakeholders, whether they are parents, they are other society members, into loop. We have to take them into confidence, and parents' orientation is very important, sir. We have to know their views, that what is their, and one most important thing is that now the selection of subjects is not limited, because now the child can opt any subjects. He can go for any profession. It is not necessary that if he has physics, chemistry, bio, then he can go for engineering. He can have this painting as well as chemistry, physics, as well as music. He can choose subjects of his own taste and he can join any profession, sir. These things are very good in this new education policy document, sir. And now it is for the principals, for the teachers, for educationists, that how to implement this, how to introduce this, how to make this successful. Because first we have to train our teachers, we have to create the infrastructure in such a way that this education policy should be introduced successfully in the schools, and we can train our students. And this totally now schools will be child-centric schools, and there will be less dropouts now in, I think, in this, when we will introduce, we will have this policy on ground in the schools. This will really help the parents and students, and schools should be ready to have this in their schools to make this successful and to get help of most of these resource persons, like so many organizations are working on this, sir, and thankful to you for taking initiative and involving such good educationists so that we can learn so many good things, we can share so many good things, and to make it a successful event, successful program. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Mehta sir, for these wonderful thoughts. You know, you talked about, you shared the major highlights and important highlights from NEP. You began by sharing the importance of early child care, you know, early child education in NEP. So many educators in the past have also applauded this, you know, attention of NEP on that part. In fact, I strongly believe the one big achievement this NEP has already done, it has already created a mass awareness about the importance of these early years. No, you also shared one very important example. You also talked about the importance of vocational studies and how it is going to create an impact, how it would make our learners more employable, you know, how it would create more entrepreneurs eventually. You also, you know, called upon all the educators that we must embrace technology. You know, we have to have, you know, become technology friendly. You also talked about the importance of flexibility which is being offered in this policy to students in terms of choosing subjects. You know, how it would create more, I would say, motivated graduates or learners from our conventional education setup. You also called upon all the educators that, you know, the government has done its part. Now, onus is on the educators. We have to make this policy successful by creating and developing infrastructure, training our teachers, training, you know, our students, creating more awareness among parents. You also talked about that this NEP is a very, very strong attempt which would make our education system a more child-centric education setup, which would, you know, help us in finding the solution of that problem of dropouts. So big thanks, Mehta sir, for sharing your views and experience. I'll be coming back to you with questions, so thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
And before I invite Shruti ma'am, I must recognize the presence of Puneet Kaur ma'am, our principal, Army Public School, Jammu Kent. Welcome, Puneet ma'am. And now I would request Shruti Sharma ma'am. Shruti ma'am, over to you. Shruti ma'am, you are on mute. Ma'am, you are logged in with two devices, so there would be a problem of echo. Aap agar ek device ko ek device se agar aap log out kar de to zyada. We all can see your screen, ma'am. Shruti ma'am, aapki awaaz nahi aa rahi, you are not audible, you are on mute, aapki screen hum log dekh pa rahe hain.
Okay, can you hear me, sir? There is echo, I think. Sir, can you hear me now?
Yes, it is better now.
And you can see my screen also, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the vision of the National Education Policy, an education system that contributes to an equitable and vibrant knowledge society by providing high quality education to all, develops a deep sense of respect towards the fundamental rights, duties and constitutional values bonding with one's country and a conscious awareness of one's role and responsibilities in a changing world. So this education policy, it's basically towards, you can say, globalization and to bring our education system at par with the world. Now it has taken so many years, I think we all know, and then we are, this is just a policy that has come. Still there are certain people who are criticizing this also, and since it is just a policy, there are no laws passed, like how much expenditure state governments and all are going to make. I think we all know this. Policy that instills skills, values and dispositions that support the responsible commitment to human rights, sustainable development and living in global being, thereby reflecting truly the well-being of the global citizen. Key principles of the new education policy: respect for diversity and local context in curriculum, in all curriculum, pedagogy and policy, equity and inclusion as the cornerstone of all the educational decisions, community participation, encouragement and facilitation of philanthropic, private and community participation, use of technology in the teaching, in teaching and learning, removing language barriers for Divyang students in educational planning and management. It emphasizes an conceptual understanding rather than rote learning and learning for exams. Unique capabilities, recognizing, identifying each student, critical thinking and creativity to encourage logical decision making and innovation, continuous review based on sustained research and regular assessment by educational experts. I think we all know that even in schools, continuous assessment is continuous assessment rather than year-end assessment. This is has been highlighted, and even the higher education MPhil has been removed, and 4 years B.Ed. Is there. I think you know that just because because normally what used to happen is when anyone in India had a degree of 3 years, he has done graduation. When he goes there, he has to take up one more year of this thing. After that only he can pursue post-graduation. So I think the policy brings us at par with the world. Universal access to early childhood care and education. Universal access for children 3 to 6 years. Access to free, safe, high quality early childhood and care education at Anganwadi, preschool, Balvatika. Foundation learning curriculum for age of group of 3 to 8 divided in 2 parts, from age 3 to 6 in early childhood and care education and age 6 to 8 in class 1st and 2nd in the primary school. Multifaceted, flexible multi-level play-based, activity-based, inquiry-based learning. The fun of learning has to be there. Preparatory class. Prior to the age of 5, every child will move to preparatory class or Balvatika, that is before class 1. multiple pathways to learning involving both formal and non-formal education modes. Build schools, promote both governments and non-governmental philanthropic organizations to build schools, learning outcomes. Focus will be on achieving desired learning outcomes at all levels. Bring back dropouts, alternative centers and peer tutoring. Expected outcomes, universalization of access from ECCE to secondary, ensure equity and inclusion, bring back 2 crores out of school children, attain SDG goals of retaining all children in schools and until completion of secondary education, improve quality and achievement of learning outcomes, foundational literacy and numeracy, focus on 21st century skills, in teaching, learning and assessment, resource sharing, school complexes, effective governance, separation of powers and common norms, overcoming the language barrier in learning, common standards for public and private school education, transforming curricular and pedagogical structure. Existing structure, as you all know, 10 plus 2. Now it is the new academic structure, as you can see. It is 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. New pedagogical and curricular structure of school education, 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. That is 3 years in Anganwadi or preschool and 12 years in school. Secondary stage, 4 years, multidisciplinary study, greater critical thinking, flexibility and student choice of subjects. Now a commerce and the bifurcation of commerce, arts and humanities will not exist. You can take various combinations of subjects. And middle stage, 3 experiential learning in the sciences, mathematics, arts, social studies and humanities. Preparatory stage, play, discovery and activity-based interactive classroom learning, and foundational stage is the multi-level play activity-based learning. National Curricular Pedagogical Framework, Early Childhood Education, NCPFECE will be drafted by NCERT. Multifaceted framework comprising of alphabets, languages, numbers, counting, colors, shapes, indoor and outdoor play, puzzles and logical thinking, problem solving, drawing, painting and other visual arts, craft, drama, puppetry, music, movement. School preparation module, a 3-month play-based school preparation module for grade 1 students to be developed by NCERT. Research and best practices will be aligned with latest research on ECCE and national and international best practices. Early childhood education, learning in the formative years, developing curiosity, logical thinking and problem solving, art and craft, music, relationship with nature, color, shapes and alphabets, etiquette, behavior and emotional development, self-identity, ethics, play-based, discovery-based learning, teamwork and collaboration. Attainment of foundational literacy and numeracy by grade 3 in the mission mode. So by grade 3, foundational skills, universal acquisition of foundational learning skills, national mission on foundational literacy and numeracy, book promotion, national book promotion policy will be formulated and public, and school libraries will be expanded. Early learning, focus on early reading and writing and mathematics. 3 months play-based school, 3 months play-based school preparation module for all grade 1 students. National repository, high quality teaching and learning resources on Diksha. Libraries, I think everybody knows this, we are currently using this platform for our teachers training also. Libraries, school libraries including digital libraries to be leveraged. Reduction in curriculum, there has been 4 essentials, critical thinking, interactive classes and experiential learning. 4 essentials, curriculum in all subjects to be reduced to its core essentials. Critical thinking, focus on critical thinking, inquiry, discovery, discussion and analysis based on teaching and learning methods of holistic education. Interactive classes, interactive teaching with reduced reduced dependency on textbook learning, questions from students will be promoted. Experiential learning, fun, creative, collaborative and exploratory activities in classroom for experiential learning and deeper student learning. Curriculum and pedagogy to be transformed by 2022 to promote skill-based and minimize road-based learning. Revision of National Curriculum Framework for School Education and National Curriculum Framework for Teacher Education 2009 by 2021. Focus on learning objectives, learning outcomes, competencies and subject integration. Competency-based education modules on preparing and implementing pedagogical plans based on competency and outcome-based education for school leaders. Integration of subjects through arts integrated, sports integrated, ICT integrated, information and communication and technology integrated, and storytelling based pedagogy, among others, as standard pedagogy. Development of scientific temper, and inculcation of knowledge and practice of human and constitutional values such as patriotism, sacrifice, non-violence, truth, honesty, peace, etc. No silos among subjects or learning. No hard separation between co-curricular or co-curricular extracurricular academic or vocational, science or humanities, sports, arts or academics. Emphasis on digital literacy, coding and computational thinking, ethical and moral reasoning. Promotion of multilingual teaching promotes states to enter into bilateral agreements with nearby states to hire language teachers. And this is based on the fact that the student, by the age of 10, if he has learned the local language, will be able to learn any other language. So English, it's not that once a child is born, he has to be trained in English. Once he knows his mother tongue, by the age of 10, he develops that the capability. He will be able to grasp any other language in the similar manner. This is after research. Mental and physical health and well-being, health checkups, reduced weight of school bags, mandatory skills, health and wellness, hiring counselors in school complexes, focus on children and with disability, inclusive and caring culture at the school. I think a lot of things we are already doing, but still it is bringing us at at par with other developed nations. And after so many years, we have been able to come up with suggestions. Innovative pedagogy, transforming teaching learning process, experiential learning, focus on experiential inquiry and discovery based teaching learning methods, integrated pedagogy, arts, sports, storytelling and ICT integrated pedagogy, promoting peer tutoring and voluntary and joyful activity under the supervision of teachers, equal weightage, no hard separation between curricular and co-curricular and extracurricular area, freedom of choosing a variety of subject and combination to be provided, bagless days to be scheduled in the academic calendar. So some certain days, like zero academic days, when children might be experiencing experiential learning through the virtual reality sessions, so they can be bagless days when the child is learning, right, through activities. Use of integration of technology. Integration of technology enabled pedagogy in classes 6 to 12. And coding, of course, is one. There are so many others, carpentry and other vocational. So the education has been focused for the vocational purpose also, right from class 6. Textbook with local content and flavor. All textbooks contain only essential. Yes, sir.
I would request, because of the time limit, you know, if you can.
Okay, sir. I will not read out everything then. I would conclude. The pressure of boards it has been decided would be reduced, and continuous assessment will be there. Even in higher education, MPhil has been removed, discontinued.
Right.
There are this thing that how much how the state governments and the government will be contributing towards the research and the budget also. Reforming examinations 9 to 12 including, now it has become one stage, 9 to 12 including board exam. I think we all are aware of these things.
Right.
The holistic progress card will be there.
Smart ke exam mein itne syllabus rehne dete hain, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Next year exam mein cover kar lenge?
Ji, sir. And it's almost over, sir. Teacher education also now 4 years BEd has been suggested, and even when anyone is undergoing the graduation, like it is 4 years, and after 1 year maybe he can exit and there will be credits and he can get certificates and diplomas accordingly. So trainings are very important for those who are existing in the system already.
आपने बहुत बहुत मेहनत करी मैम उसको तैयार करने में, श्रुति मैम.
मैम का म्यूट हो गया है.
मैम यू आर म्यूट, आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही अभी ना। मैम यू आर श्रुति मैम यू आर ऑन म्यूट। मैम यू आर ऑन म्यूट श्रुति मैम।
ओके
राइट, आपने बहुत बहुत मेहनत करी मैम इसको, यू नो यू कवर्ड द एंटायर डॉक्यूमेंट एंटायर पॉलिसी इन अ वंडरफुल वे। आपके लिए हमें डेडिकेटेड अलग से एक सेशन कराना पड़ेगा।
I know sir, we actually attended a training recently on this only, and for all the teachers we had conducted this. So
wonderful. नहीं बहुत कुछ आपने, it was a very useful और जिस तरीके से you know you explained things, you talked about that NEP's a strong attempt to put India's education system on a global level in multiple aspects. You also say you know you almost cover all you know all the aspects of NEP of how it is going to empower our learners, our teachers, our society. You also talked about a lot of important things like peer tutoring, ECC. You talked about the expected outcomes from NEP. And you also talked about the flexibility of subjects, how it is going to create that desired change. Talked about that NEP is offering new art separation between art and science subjects, co-curricular activities. You also talked about you know the desired changes in teachers' training, and you know the kind of BEd program NEP is talking about. So how it is going to empower our trainers, empower our educators, and those empowered educators would create empowered students, and eventually empowered society, and eventually empowered country. So you know all are connected. So big thanks, ma'am, you know, for doing this so much of hard work for us. And for you know, letting us know how this NEP is going to create impact in Delhi South. Big thanks.
Thank you so much, sir.
And I'll come back to the question. Thank you, ma'am. Right now, I will request Jaswinder, sir, if you can have your perspective, your thought.
Yeah, thank you, Rajulji, and good afternoon, everybody. I am going to touch upon one important aspect. सुचि मैम आपके यहाँ से आवाज जा रहा है, आप उसे म्यूट कर देंगे श्रुति मैम?
सॉरी
यार। सो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू टच अपॉन इज वन इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग व्हिच ऑलमोस्ट एवरीबॉडी इज टॉक्ड अबाउट एंड दैट इज टीचर ट्रेनिंग प्लस एवरीबॉडी इज आल्सो टॉक्ड अबाउट टेक्नोलॉजी एंड व्हाट आई से इज दैट इफ वी ऑल अंडरस्टैंड दैट टू मेक दिस पॉलिसी वर्क